we are just so happy to be back and to carry on the legacy that was made by Miliani Takis, if some of you guys remember. She started the podcast last year, and we're hoping to just
continue it, her legacy.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so let's get straight into it by saying we, as peer mentors, are here to just help incoming students, not only freshmen, to guide, support, and advise an inclusive space where everyone feels comfortable and connected and overall supported.
Yes, yes.
All right, so can you explain more of the dynamic within peer mentors?
Yes, we have our fuel partnerships, but not only that, we also have committees as well in peer mentorship. We have the Fuel Committee, the Spirit Committee, Bulletin, and PR, which is Public Relations.
But we're going to talk about that in another episode.
Yes, actually, we do have an episode about that in episode, yeah. The first episode of the podcast.
Yeah, the first everyone made earlier, last year. But in this year, we are going to have to redo some of our things, right? We're going to have to reintroduce our new people, our new group.
Reintroduce. Yeah.
And we'll
some
get right
people.
So some information about this podcast that we are going to be hosting, we're going to try to do weekly episodes where we just feature different hosts, we talk to different people, give interviews, and just overall talk about our high school experience and what to expect.
Yes.
Speaking of expectations, what do you think this year is going to look like?
This year is definitely going to be a harder year just because I'm trying to figure out the right words. Just because we're upperclassmen and there's more expectations and more responsibilities for us, especially if you're more college-bound, as well as younger people looking up to us, but not really, I guess. I don't know. Also, as peer mentors, we have the responsibility to care for one another.
Did you, look up to...
I did. When I was younger, I did look up to the upperclassmen.
They were scary.
They were. I was intimidated by them. But now we are them. Yeah. What? That's so crazy.
Time flies.
It really does. definitely going to be a lot more work, but, you know, that's life.
Would you say the work, did you expect this amount of work?
Honestly, I expected more.
I mean, okay, so let's take an example. You know, like, in the movies and shows, do they kind of lay out a proper example of what high school is like?
Absolutely not, just because it's all full of stereotypes. It's all fantasy, really. In high school service, we have a very inclusive school. You know how the stereotypical, like, jocks would make fun of the nerds? It's not really like that. People are welcoming guests. And then also, like, food fights and stuff in cafeterias. People don't really eat in the cafeteria. I mean, some people do, but most people eat, they have their designated little spots.
I want to see a food fight. That would be funny.
Maybe
even be a part of it, but we don't condone that.
No.
But yes, do you like your little spots that you chose?
I do like my little spots that I chose.
They are very memorable and sentimental.
Yes.
They mean a lot.
What is some of the best advice that you were given going into high school?
Oh.
And things that actually worked for you?
Oh geez, that's a hard question. Because I guess I don't really remember much advice that I was given. I am the youngest of four siblings. And I feel like a lot of my experience in high school was a reflection of theirs for sure. Mm-hmm. I remember coming home from elementary school and just seeing my sister, like, passed out on the floor because she was so, like, literally she would sleep on the floor. But I just remember seeing my siblings, and I definitely lived, like, my high school experience was defined by them because, for example, like, my brother was super sporty. He loved skiing and running, and he was just that kind of kid. And my other brother was more school-oriented, and I just took advice from both of them, trying to figure out, do I want to be a more sporty kid, or just, but either way, for me, I ended up kind of trying to live all of their experiences at once instead of just focusing on my own. And I feel like that kind of overwhelmed me because I couldn't really figure out what my goal in high school was. But I'm so happy now I was able to figure that out. Sophomore year was so hard, but we got through it.
Yeah, I'm glad you
and
released.
Now I finally understand my priorities and what I value the most.
Yay, I'm proud of you for figuring that out.
And I know you're a really big family person, and I know you really take a lot of advice from your family.
I do. In saying so, the main advice that I got told from others was to join as many clubs as you could. Do whatever you want to do, because honestly, high school goes by so quickly. You don't even think. Like, you blink and you're out of here. Like, really enjoy all the experiences that you can. Go to the dances. Go hang out with that friend. Go tell that person that you like them. Like, time flies by so fast.
Dude, that is such a good
do point. What you want to do. Live it up. YOLO.
Yeah, because high school is such a small portion in your life that everything you do here, ultimately, like, just the little things, do they really matter?
No, because who remembers their high school experience?
I mean, just
if you ask your parents, they don't really remember. So, like, live it up.
Are you going to remember, like, that one time you submitted a late assignment? Does it really matter?
Nah.
Just live your life, man.
But also, do good in school, guys.
Because it does set up your future.
Yeah, yeah. Get good grades. Actually try. Put the effort in.
It is worth it.
It is, yes. Especially if you're college bound. But even if you're not, try and put effort in.
You mentioned school clubs a little earlier. So what are some of the ones that you joined and actually enjoyed?
I did pop into a few clubs every once in a while. Popped into a partners club, which is a very social inclusion run by Mr. A. They are in C Hall. I forgot which room, but I think everybody knows by now where Mr. A's room is. But go say hi to them. They have their club every Tuesday during lunch. And then also I've popped by a Filipino club and as well as a Zumba club, I know.
Oh my gosh,
I don't know if they're doing that anymore, but yeah. And then art club, I don't remember what it was called, but it was like
NHS.
Yeah, NHS. National Society? No. Yeah, it was something like that. But I also tried that out. And there's obviously a bunch of more in clubs that y'all should go check out.
Yeah. You mentioned Filipino club, and I actually want to get into that. I was part of the Korean club.
Yes.
For a little
That's
bit.
What I was about to say. Yeah.
Yeah, just like a little bit more about us. Like, I was in Ukrainian club because I am a Ukrainian. I moved to America, or my family moved to America a couple years ago, and that's just a bit about me. I speak fluent Ukrainian. I'm really passionate about where I come from. And if you guys ever want to get a bit more information about what's going on in Ukraine, how you can help, just go to, what's her name? I forgot the teacher's name, but I know it's in Upper D Hall. It's where the seminar rooms are. They have Ukrainian club every Friday, and you could just learn a lot. You can help. It's an awesome place to be. It's a really nice environment. But that's what I'm passionate about.
Yeah. Yeah, as I was saying, Filipino club, I am part Filipina as well as Mexican. There's also Spanish club too, as well as environmental club. And women's club. I'm pretty sure Louie and Sabdi and Anna
our
previous mentors founded that or started that club. Go check it out.
Go woman.
Yeah. Woman power. What is it called?
Girl power.
Girl power.
I think we should give a moment of silence for all our past mentors, our past seniors. We really do value them and everything they left behind for us, the clubs that they built, the lessons that we got from them. We appreciate everything that our past upperclassmen did for us, and I cannot be more excited to be an upperclassman. It is such an exciting thing, and I'm really happy that we could just, in later episodes, we're going to have some perspectives from our upperclassmen and our underclassmen?
Yes, and our underclassmen, yeah. What is our quote of the day, Oksana?
Quote of the day, okay. Every day in class, in our peer mentor class, we have a quote of the day and our mission statement. We already mentioned our statement earlier, which was just to guide, support incoming students. But our quote of the day today was, if you can't do big things, do small things very well. So how would you interpret that?
I would interpret as, you know, you have big accomplishments, but you have smaller steps going, leading into that big accomplishment. Also, like, small acts of kindness go a long way. You know, just smiling to someone and waving to someone can make their day and go beyond what you believe. Also, it kind of reminded me of a quote from our previous podcast.
One of the first ones.
Yeah.
Good cameo. As our final step, can you tell us what the song of the day is?
All Right by Kendrick Lamar.
Ayo.
Yeah.
As a good one. It means everything will be all right, no matter where you are in life or what's going on, you will be okay. Just push through it. And so this is a wrap to our first podcast of the year. This is your host, Oksana.
And Rosabella Leone.
And we are so happy to get to know you and talk to you this year.
Bye. Ta-ta.
All my life, hard times like, bad trips like, Nazareth, I'm f***ed up, homie, you f***ed up, but if God got us, then we gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright.